At some point in Excel, you're going to need to work with percentages. But there's a bit of confusion around this issue because you can format as a percentage and you can calculate as a percentage, and they're actually two different things. So in this video, I'm going to explain all. Stay tuned. The first thing to understand about percentages is there's a percentage format and a percentage formula. So something like 50% is just a percentage format. It's half. The decimal equivalent will be 0.5. To check that, you just click the cell here, click the comma here, and it converts to 0.5. So think about a scale that goes from 0 through to 1, where 0 is nothing, 1 is everything. In percentage terms, that's 0% through to 100%. Think about halfway along the scale. You know, you're talking 0.5, half, 50%, half. Both of those are halfway along the scale. Maybe 3/4 long, you get 0.75 for the number, and 75% for the percentage. So that's the relationship between percentages and numbers. The 0-point-something number is what converts to a percentage. And so, you know, if you take in, say, 0.75, convert that to a percentage, you get 75%. Now let's take a bunch of numbers here. A lot of people make the mistake, especially when they're beginners, of selecting the whole range of numbers and simply converting to a percentage format. As you can see, there's huge numbers here. Because if you think back to, say, 0.75 here, it multiplied that by 100 to get 75, and then put the percent on the end. So you can't just do that here. What you need to do instead is to do a calculation. So let's go back to the numbers there. I'll just press Ctrl Z to undo my last step. The first thing I'm going to do is to get a total. So just using AutoSum here, there's the total of all those numbers. I'm also just going to name the cell. So if I click that, go to your name box here, just give it a name called total. And I'm going to use that in my formula in just a second. So here, to work out the percentage of each of these numbers, you simply divide, so you start with equals, take the number here, and divide by the total. That will give you a 0-point-something number, which you can then convert to a percentage. So if I just take this and auto-fill it down, there's all my 0-point-something numbers for each of these whole numbers. And if I convert those to a percentage, there's the percentages. You may or may not need to show a few more decimal places just to show the accuracy there. But if I was to total these percentages up, again, using AutoSum, you get 100%. Now, let's take another example. So let's say you're buying a house. Okay, the house price is, say, $400,000. And let's say you're talking about a fixed interest rate here. So your interest rate might be, say, 5.5%. Now, to calculate 5.5% of 400,000, to work out what interest you're paying, your formula would be equals one multiplied by the other. Okay, and 22,000 is the interest component of that figure. Okay, I'm going to finish with two examples, business examples. Here in Australia, we have something called the GST. It's like a general services tax, a sales tax, which gets added onto a base price, and that goes to the government. So it's got a current value of 10%. So let's just write in base price, GST, total. And let's say the base price for your computer is, say, $1,000. The GST, to calculate that, is 10% of $1,000. And like we saw before, it's one times the other. So let's take your base price, multiply it by the 10%. The total, then, is just these two added together. I'm just using AutoSum to get it done quickly. And that's your total. Now, quite often, you do want the separate columns, so that process is fine. And obviously, then you can copy this formula down for as many prices as you have. But if you want to do it in one step rather than two, and this might look a little bit funny the first time you see it, but you do it like this. You say equals your $1,000 times the 10%. You then add on the base price. So you're using A20 in this case twice. The first use of it is to work out the 10% of the base price, and then add on the actual base price. That gives you 1100, but it's all done in one cell, so you don't actually need this middle one if that's the way you want to go. Now, if you want to reverse the process, so let's say you've got $1,100 as your total price, and you want to strip off the GST to get back to your base price. The way to think about this, the total is in effect 110% of the original price. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to say equals the total price, I'm going to divide it by, in brackets, I say 100% plus the 10%. 100% plus 10% is 110%. So you do that and you get to your base price. That's it for this one. Cheers, guys. See you for the next one.